member of Spoonfed Tribe. I've already figured it out because I feel like I've done this before. Hey, how are you?
I'm doing good. How are you doing?
Yeah, tell everybody your name out there and what do you do for the band?
I'm Jerome, 57. I play bass and drums and sing
and dance
all kinds of stuff for Spoonfed Tribe.
All the good stuff, yeah. So you guys, y'all have been around for a while, kind of circling around the area. And tell me about your favorite spot right now. Like, where's your favorite place to go aside from Dallas? Obviously, I know you love to play here.
Yeah, we love Denver. We love Houston. We love New Orleans. We love Kansas City.
Yeah.
All around, you know, we've been further out. We've actually had a great time in LA. Every time we've been to LA, people talk a lot of trash about LA.
Yeah.
And every time we've been there, we've had a great show, lots of people. It's been awesome.
No, so, I have to say something about LA. Any band that I've known that it's gone, there's a lot of love out there.
There's a lot of love for music.
Yeah. Like, you know, and you would think that maybe they're, you know, desensitized to it with all the the famous people out there. But no, actually,
no,
they come out and support.
Yeah, we've had a great time out there. Yeah.
And so what about, like, here, being home? Like, do you guys, I mean, are you here often? Are you traveling a lot? Is it one of those, like, you're sick of traveling, or are you guys?
We got a little sick of traveling a few years ago, but then we started back up, and we got a few good festivals this year and some road trips for later in the year. We're taking maybe about a month off before summer really hits, and then we're doing a few festivals and a big run through the Midwest and Colorado. And
nice.
It's going to be awesome.
Now, I love Colorado.
Yeah, we have a great
I will
time
say,
out there.
Yeah, that and the music scene there is pretty damn good too.
Yeah.
Have you paid attention to any other local bands out there in Colorado?
Yeah, we got a few friends out there that moved from here and they live in Colorado and they're killing it. Yeah.
Yeah, we ended up we went out there to go cover a hobo. Yeah.
Nice.
But he's a musician. He's really awesome. Casper Allen, you guys check him out. But we went out there to go cover him, and we ended up at this amazing house party with this amazing, like, a couple of bands and just people rocking out like it was the 90s again. Like, I'm from the 90s.
Yeah, yeah.
You too, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
oh,
that brings me to, how long have you guys been playing together?
We've been playing together since the earth cooled.
I remember that. I was there.
Long time ago.
And so you guys have any kind of, like, I mean, are there members in your band that you know, like, that guy's the sloppy one, that guy's the lazy one? I mean,
everybody knows those. If you watch us, you'll figure all that out.
So it's one of those, if I have all of you guys in the same room, I'll be like, who's the lazy one? Everybody will point, like, directly at one person.
Yeah, you just wait 5 minutes and you'll be like, oh, you're the lazy one.
Oh, that
okay.
one, the one that didn't raise
oh,
his
you're
hand.
Oh, you're the talkative one, okay, yeah.
Got you. Yeah, that's very cool, man. But it's really good to be here tonight. Here, we're at Trees. You guys are going on. You guys are headlining today because that's the only way you do it.
That's right.
Am I right? Yeah.
In Dallas, yeah.
In Dallas?
That's for sure.
And do you guys get a lot of love like that everywhere else? Or are you guys kind of like, kind of creeping up?
Yeah, no. I mean, we'd have to go to a Seattle or Portland or New York or Florida or something far out to be the openers. We pretty much headline our own tours all through Midwest and the, you know, near West.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so what inspires you guys? I mean, doing this for, you know, let's say a decade or a little bit longer.
Yeah.
I mean, what keeps you going? What keeps you going?
We're independent.
Ah, so, there you go.
I mean, really, no one, I don't think anyone has ever told me what to play, ever.
Well,
I don't think anybody's ever told me what song to play or what.
So it works.
Doesn't fit because the times change and blah, blah,
right.
blah.
Right, blah, 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 blah.
I don't think I've ever heard anybody
say that. Do you think maybe they've told you, but you're like, shut up, I know what I'm doing. Yeah.
No, I would probably listen to them.
Oh,
it depends on who it is.
Yeah,
I would probably
exactly.
listen to them. But no one ever tells, I mean, because we put ourselves in a position where we make the decision to do whatever we want to do, you know.
So yeah, so there you go.
I think that's part of the art is doing what you want to do and having the people watch what you want to do, you know.
And there's a definite trend of that going on now. So many bands emerging, and a lot of them are choosing to stay independent, so that's something to think about. Meanwhile,
you can do it from your living room. You can do it, you get a program on a computer, record some music, take a picture, go from your living room. You'll be in France in 6 months.
There you go. Do it right now. And that's a message from Spoonfed Tribe. You guys look them up on, what do you say, CD Baby?
CD Baby, SpoonfedTribe.com.
There you go. Go look them up, like them, love them, come out to the shows, because that's what we're about to do. We're about to watch. So we'll see you guys later. Thank you. And thank you, guy that was getting naked behind the camera.